आई एम जरगर जहूर, एक्सटीन फैकल्टी ऑफ फाइन आर्ट्स, जामिया मिलिया इस्लामिया, न्यू दिल्ली। इन दिस मॉड्यूल आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट हाउ टू पेंट ऑन अ टिंटेड पेपर यूजिंग गौश। वी हैव ऑलरेडी ट्राइड गौश ऑन सेवरल डिफरेंट पेपर्स, पिन अ वाइट शीट ऑन द बोर्ड एंड टेप पेस्टल शीट ऑन इट यूजिंग अ स्कॉच टेप, ऑल्सो पॉपुलरली नोन एज सेलो टेप, फ्रॉम ऑल फोर साइड। यू कैन यूज थिन कलर और थिक कलर एज यू लाइक। हेयर वी आर स्टार्टिंग विथ येलो कलर। Take a good quality of pastel sheet and start with any color you wish to. This tape will prevent color from spreading in unwanted area, and after the completion of painting, once the tape has been removed, there will be gray border, the color of the tinted sheet all around. This border looks beautiful with the rest of the colored area. The gouache is also called body color, but body color is wrongly used for all paintings done with gouache and were introduced in 1937, but before that the only way to produce opaque areas was by mixing white that can produce tints of a color that are largely opaque. In actuality, it refers to the use of opaque colors for creating highlights or dense flat areas which are opaque. This is a technique which has been used in watercolor for many centuries. Nowadays, designers' gouache are also available in the market. In the lower area, apply burnt sienna. And near the bottom of the painting, it will be darker than the area near center. Tinted paper gives a very nice look to the painting when some of the base color is left uncolored. Actually, the tint of the base becomes a color itself when the base is judiciously left blank in some areas, and in some other areas it is painted over. Here we will start with the yellow color, which has slightly greenish tinge. Notice how bold patches are being applied, and some areas are deliberately left unpainted. Take care to leave blank spaces in such a way that it won't become too obvious, rather it will look like background color is peeping through the coat of main color that is being applied. It merges with the background color, so well you hardly feel there is any color at the back. It rather becomes part of the painting. After the medium yellow, we have to apply dull color in some places. And in the middle, we will apply brighter yellow so that it will draw your eyes to the center of the painting. You may start with any color. You can start with blue, you can start with red, the choice is yours. There is no hard and fast rule about it which color to start with. But normally, it is better to take middle tone first and apply brighter or duller color in specific areas as per requirements. You have to proceed gradually from middle to dark and from brighter to duller color. In the area that is slightly near the middle and towards left corner, apply bluish gray with the tinge of green in it. It is a color that is a mixture of blue, green and gray. Some yellow mixed with burnt sienna is applied near the bluish gray painted earlier. Then the green color that has a little bit of blue as well as some gray mixed is applied near the bottom. One important thing to remember is that for this kind of coating only a flat brush must be used, maybe a brush 1 inch or 2 inch in width. Now let's get back to the painting demonstration. Take some more light yellow patches or paint it selectively in some areas. Over this, a few careful horizontal strokes will form the grass on the ground. It will also give an impression like foliage. Note how the color changes in look with just a bit mixture of any other color. First light yellow and burnt sienna, then grayish green. It is always better to take a look at different pupils' work and styles, especially if you want to learn more deeply about any subject. It is also true about fine arts. So besides seeing and learning from the demonstration here, it is a sincere advice to all learners that they ought to see what others have done and how their work differs in look from the demonstration given here. Almost all artists famous or not so famous alike have done their paintings on tinted papers too. Some of the famous artists to have used tinted paper as the base were William Turner and Leonardo da Vinci, Albert Durer, etc. In in case you are not able to get a tinted paper with the right kind of tint that you need. It is also possible to make your own tinted paper. For this, what you have to do is first get some good quality drawing paper, preferably hot pressed. Stretch this sheet of paper on any flat surface, a table, a drawing board, or even ground if it is clean enough. In most cases, unless it is too big to handle without pinning or taping, there will be no need to tape or pin the corners of paper. Once the paper is flat, dissolve 1/2 ounce of gelatin in 18 ounces of water. Then take some dry powdered color, dissolvable in water, and prepare the tint as per your choice and liking. Remember that after drying it, the tone prepared becomes fairly dark, hence you need to make it much lighter in tone than what you feel is the right tone when wet. Then we again move to the center area and apply blue, thin blue only. In the same area where we had already applied grayish blue earlier. As you proceed with paint, you will have to visualize how you want your painting to look finally. If it is to be a sunset, then the whole painting will have a warm hue overall. If it is a painting of a bright day, it will have natural colors and directional light to make it more dramatic and so on. Here we are making a neutral, somewhat dull, stromedy. For achieving a particular feel, what color is to be used is something that comes with experience. The same shade, the same tone, and more importantly, the feel may be achieved using different combinations of colors. So don't feel shy to experiment. Thank you. leave your reins free. Try painting different ways using different materials and different subjects. This is how you can make your own tinted paper. Making your own tinted paper is not only fun. It also gives you a different kind of satisfaction and also creates a bond with the painting that is much stronger than a painting done on the ready-made tinted paper. It is better to try gouache technique first. Before you use any other technique, watercolor, acrylic color or oil color, it is better to practice gouache first. In the end, some final touches are required with yellowish white, and then some more final touches with dark tones are applied judiciously. And there on the foliage area will make it look more natural. These yellow patches look like dry leaves laying on the ground. It does not mean that a color paper which has a strong base color cannot be used. Strong color tinted papers may be used, but then it will be more difficult to get the effect of other colors right. And it may overpower all other colors. Hence, precaution has to be taken in using such a strong base color. When the base is strong, it will play the role of major color. It has more flexibility. It will give you a more confidence. If you are working on tinted paper, as here in this case, you don't need to use middle tones much, because the base itself will mostly have middle tones. Several different tones of green in multiple coats will have to be applied. You have to think where you want light foliage to appear and where you want dark foliage to appear. When the base is strong, it will play the role of major color, and colors that will actually be applied will become, for strong highlights, you have to use white color or very light shade of any other color that can represent the highlights on the subject. Depth is acceptable with dark shades of any color where it is required. The sky area, which we had deliberately kept very light, mostly dull yellow for stormy effect, is now the area for giving a final look to the painting. Stormy clouds are made using finer yellow-blue tones in the sky. This completes the look and provides depth and scale both. Remember, the coloring must be done in such a manner that all four corners are slightly darker than the center area of the painting. This will help contain the eye within the picture. This is the way followed by all great masters of painting. Painting is like meditation. It is more to be felt than be read or be narrated like a story. It comes from within. One has to feel after seeing a painting as if he has traveled in times and is present in that era or place what has been painted. If these feelings come after seeing the painting, then the painting is successful. A picture speaks a thousand words. Thus, a good painting needs no explanation. It is self-explanatory. Try to achieve that perfection and you will become an accomplished artist.